It's a very sobering moment. I'm grateful to you all for organizing this event, which on one hand brings so many painful memories for so many around the world. But it's also, as you said, if we keep silent, this will continue. So I would start by urging all the viewers to join TGTE and all who advocate for peace and justice and truth before reconciliation can really happen. I will just say a few words. As mentioned, I was in Sri Lanka in December 2014. We were looking at the continued military occupation of the northern and eastern provinces and how the conflation of land, race, and religion among the majority was denying and continues to deny basic economic, cultural, and political rights in the country to the non-Buddhist minority groups, especially the Tamils. During field research, what I was devastated by was to see how the horrors of war continue to weigh upon the psyche of the nation. And the worst that continues even today is the absence of accounting for thousands who went missing during and after the war. Numbers vary. In the video we heard, the government officials have said these are just fake news, nobody was disappeared. But just this January, President Rajapaksa declared that everyone who was missing is dead, and they'll be issuing death certificates, not recognizing how painful it was for the families who are still waiting. The world knows that at the end of the war, in May 2009, thousands surrendered with Reverend Father Francis Joseph to NOR Army Commander Shavendra Silva's 58th Division. Families watched as their loved ones surrendered and boarded buses, never to be seen again. So if we are to believe that this was fake news, nobody disappeared, and that if the missing are dead, not just the families, but the international community deserves a response from the Sri Lankan government as to if they are dead, how did they die? Who killed them? When, where, why, and how were they killed? Where are the remains? How long has the truth been silenced? It is astonishing that the administration, which was in power at the time of the end of the war, is back in power, has complete impunity, sending the message that if this island nation can have impunity for thousands and thousands of people who have disappeared, numbers range from 60,000 to over 120,000 people are missing, the second largest number of the missing in the world. It sends the message that any country can do the same. Mothers, daughters, wives, people that I met during the course of my field research, I had gone to look at the issue of land and how displacement continues in Sri Lanka. This was December 2014, when the Rajapaksa government would not allow any UN and other agencies to come in and investigate. People got the word that a researcher was there. I was not prepared for it, but I met hundreds and hundreds of people who showed up despite the harassment, despite the intimidation to testify, bringing the ICRC reports that their loved ones are missing. I met a mother whose three sons have disappeared, and she was still waiting with photos she had received that perhaps they are alive somewhere. She lived with fear as the CID, the Criminal Investigation Department, continued to knock at her door in the evenings to threaten her and the only son that still remained, 30-year-old. I'll never forget meeting Subhatra, whose husband surrendered and was taken away and was missing for 5 years. Her daughter was born after her husband went missing. Her 5-year-old knows about her father's disappearance, but she has never met him. After 5 years of knocking at different doors, she was told that she should take a death certificate of her husband. And she said, I'm tired of being made to be silent. I am going to speak up. This was before the elections, and she met me in the basement of a church to bring the ICRC report and demand that the world stands up with her and asks, where is her husband? Where is the father of a five-year-old who would be now 10 years old in 2020 and she's not yet seen her father? It is very vital that I, as Anuradha, as an Indian, as an American, stand together with the families of those who have disappeared in Sri Lanka. It is an important responsibility for each one of us. As long as there is no justice, there will be no peace in Sri Lanka, and there will be no peace in this world.